Hey guys, it's Moonlander back with another horror movie review, and today we're going to be looking at the movie called Rupture. Oh, no.
They need us.
Rupture stars Naomi Rapace from Prometheus and Michael Chiklis from The Shield. And it's about a single mom with a young son, and she gets abducted by these people that want to run experiments on her.
You.
This might feel a little bit cold.
What's G1012X?
The genetic code. We're trying to rupture that part of your genes.
And she's been selected based on her medical records for these tests. And basically what they're trying to do, she's not the only one. They take her to this facility and they have other people there too. But they see better signs in her. And they want to rupture a gene which triggers into the next stage of human evolution. And they seem to have heightened senses, and they also, for some reason, have the ability to morph their face into like a distorted face, but that's all you really get to see of it. The things I liked about this movie is the facility in which they take the main character to, and they're keeping all these people at, is a pretty cool building. It's very red, and it's just sent like a unique, but also like a old abandoned building in a way. And I thought that was, they picked a pretty cool place to make the facility at. And one part of getting that gene to rupture is they ask these people what their greatest fears are, and the rupture is induced by terrors. So they try to get the rupture to happen by scaring the shit out of the people. And whether that be spiders, for the main character it was spiders. So you get a few like really creepy scenes where they put a tube down on her and trap part of her body, eventually her face. And they feed poisonous spiders in through the tube, so they're stuck in this entrapped part enclosed around her body. And then when she, there's a part where she does attempt to escape, and when she gets a look at some of the other people, and I thought they had the potential, they could have done some really cool stuff with that, but they were pretty basic things like fear of falling, or one guy, they had his eyes held open and they were making this wall come forward with his father's voice playing and pictures of his father. So I guess he was afraid of his dad, but they didn't really get too creative with that stuff. And another creepy part of this movie is all of the staff of this facility, the doctors and the henchmen, they all have the same demeanor. They definitely don't see anything wrong with what they're doing. It's just business. This is what they have to do. And I thought they did a good job of making that feel like it was true for all of the facility staff. And I thought that was pretty creepy. And then probably one of the best scenes in the movie is early on in the movie when they abduct her. They tape her face up, except her eyes for some reason. Maybe just because it looked different. I don't know. But anyway, this female doctor gets on there and starts cutting her pants off with these long scissors. And she's just like gliding them up her leg. And when she finishes, she's like, nod once if you want me to remove your panties to make peeing easier. You have a long journey ahead of you. And that part was pretty crazy. But, yeah, I mean, that's about it. I mean, I didn't really love anything about this movie. It's all just, like, mediocre. Like, the things I didn't like about the movie is the small amount of, like, mutated forms of the people that had ruptured. All that really happened was, like, their faces became distorted. And it wasn't that cool, or, I mean, it wasn't gross, really. It just looked like they didn't really put much effort into that. Yeah, and then the ending of the movie is kind of odd. Like, they try to wrap it up, and, like, it just seems like a quick fix for an ending. It didn't really seem like a complete movie, exactly. I mean, they do kind of give you some sort of closure, but I don't know if they ran out of budget or what, but the ending seemed a little off to me. So my final thoughts on this movie is it's okay, but you're not missing anything by skipping this one. There's nothing all that exciting about it. And I mean, like I said, the mutations weren't that cool. They're actually really pretty boring. So I'm going to give this movie a 5 out of 10. Alright you guys, thanks for watching, and please like, comment, and subscribe. See you on the next video.